It is amazing
how the mysteries of life work.
I mean, after every dark night, there is a bright day.
And that always gives me hope. Sort of like the song Waterfalls.
Well, let me back up for a minute.
In that song,
I just started reflecting on my life as if it was a storm, you know, and how many storms have. And I looked up, and I was like, wow, look at this rainbow. So, hey, I wrote that song from my heart. Turned out to be our biggest hit.
TLC sold countless number of records, but record sales to me aren't what success is in my eyes. The most important thing to me is that I take my experiences and the knowledge that I have and share it with the world.
I'm getting my skills on as a professional photographer.
I never shut the camera off. The camera followed me into my dreams.
You get to see it from my point of view.
Part of the purpose of the documentary is so that people can get to know me up close and personal.
Throughout my career, I've gone through several things. And, you know, I've been called crazy. I pretty much just want to set the record straight.
I try to dig into myself as well.
Okay, it's recording. Give me. Give me on that side. On that side right there.
What are you looking forward to
on this trip right here?
Releasing all the toxins from out of my body.
I'm looking forward to 30 days of focusing totally on self.
I hope that, you know, in a month you see some major changes. That's what this trip is all about. Coming here and getting the stuff on tape so you can see what 30 days in the bush can do for you. So that is the plan, but I always say that that's the plan because things always change. Feel like I'm on a journey sometimes. Don't really know quite where I'm headed. Let's just say I'm gonna take everyone on a magical journey, okay? It's going to be the wonderful world of Left Eye.
according to numerology.
Number one is about knowledge and birth. It's learn about Lisa. Learn about yourself.
We made it to the waterfall. Right there, right behind you.
I wish all this. People would say, what do you want to be when you grow up? And my answer would be, in the jungle, naked, friends with the animals. You're in the jungle, I'm naked, and I'm friends with the animals. It doesn't get any better than that.
In the beginning, I was real tiny for my age. My mom said when they first brought me out to her, after she had me, she said I scared her. All she could see was these big black, like I looked like a little alien, like, doing all this crazy stuff, trying to see her, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She took me home, and she could not get me to sit down.
No.
I'm self-sufficient at like one. I was running at 7 months. No one really knew where I was going and what I was going to get into. As a little girl, there were gifts that I received from my parents. My mother's side of the family is more artistically inclined. And everyone in my father's side of the family is musically inclined. My father was in the army band. My father plays almost every instrument known to man. It is amazing to sit here and watch him pick up a harmonica and put that down, go jump on the piano, put that down, throw the drums, play the clarinet. As a little girl, everything was natural for me. I could play the piano at 4, you know, I could come home from the movies and remember the theme from Close Encounters of a Third Kind and sit down and figure it out. You know, that bugged my mother and my father out. Growing up, all of the talents that I had, it was almost as if, why can't everybody do this?
Good evening with Lisa Lopes. We're leaving the 80s in style and hitting the 90s, hotter and fresher than ever.
Me, my sister, and my brother used to put together shows for my mother some days while she was away at work. She'd come home and we'd say, Mom, sit on the couch. We got a show for you.
Hi, how you doing?
There were so many talent shows that I was involved with in either one aspect or another. Whether it was being in the front doing the rapping or being the background dancer. Very artistic. I know how to draw. I also know how to sew. I modeled. It didn't matter as long as I was involved.
Anything you want to say to your fans?
Yeah. Just remember that y'all see me on this videotape. 10 years from now, y'all see me in the movies.
Tell them say no to drugs.
Yeah. And say no to drugs.
Thank you very much.
When I want to say something, I should say it. See, this is the hard part of his documentary, trying to figure something out about myself. And getting things off my chest. Thinking about it. I had some difficulties when I was growing up. I'd say the problems that I did have stemmed from, how can I put this? My father was very strict. There were a lot of rules. My father was in the military. He's very dominant. He was a sergeant.
Take charge, Sarge.
I never told you stories about my dad.
We only like that, you know.
When we lived with my dad, mm-hmm. He was a drill sergeant, for real.
Oh, yeah?
We would come home, I don't care if it was 3 a.m. If it was something that wasn't right, he'd wake us up. Let's write a bottle! Let's write a bottle! Get downstairs right now! We would jump out the bed and we would run downstairs
can't.
And we would line up. Like soldiers.
What?
We would line up, chest out straight like this. And he would walk. He would walk in front of us like this. How many times did the three of you look at that pen on the ground and not stop and think to pick it up? How many times did you step over the pen and not stop and think, pick it up?
Damn.
And we'd be all looking at the pen like, now pick it up.
He was a very dominant man. I mean, he was the king of the castle. Don't even question him. Don't say, why, Daddy? Because I said so. Whenever I did bad in school, I got the heavy-duty punishment. No TV, no radio, no front porch, no backyard, no boyfriends, no nothing. Sit in your room and think. He was kind of abusive when it came to my mother. You know, they'd get into their little arguments and stuff, but he'd get a little bit physical. My mother and father had been together for 12 years before they got divorced. My mother took me, my sister and brothers, we left Philadelphia, we went to Florida. She took care of us and worked and came home and made sure that we ate, we had a roof over our heads and everything. My mother was a very, very strong person, and I didn't realize how strong she was until I got older. But during my teenage years, the family kind of got separated at one point. And I end up with my father's side of the family, staying with my grandmother. And my Nana, she used to play with our heads.
Uh-huh.
So anyway, when I was living with her, you don't even understand. You see, Mommy Dearest? That whole situation, I'm not exaggerating. Hiding the iron
and
going hanging. To school with wrinkled clothes, can't wash my hair, or will run up the water bill, telling me that the church clothes she bought me still belong to her because she bought them, so I only look good in church. My grades started to go down because of so many problems. Couldn't concentrate, so my dad used to put me on punishment, one report card to the next. So that's why I stayed on punishment. But one thing that I could do, which was really strange, was drink. You know, my father come over and check on me every weekend. We'd have the case of beer, you know. And hey, we'd get down. And that was one of the ways I got a lot of attention. When I was 15, I could actually drink a large amount of alcohol and not get tipsy. So that was my thing, you know. I would drink. And my father would say, look at her go, look at her go. I left my house several times. I didn't know where I was going. I'd have to say back then there were hard times for me. I had become so numb. But every time that there is a struggle, it is nothing but a preparation for what's yet to come.
They're killing innocent people by the wink of an eye. Drug dealers helping kids to get all high. They don't care about nothing. They have no home. They're either living with the gang or all alone. Guys have 20 kids, never had a wife. Well, that's what you get when you live street life.
But hey, I'm a dreamer, and I set my goals very high. So from a little girl on up, there were big things that I wanted to do. Ruling the world, you know. I'm one of those people who I believe in something to the fullest. I mean, I believe in it from my heart, and hey, strange things happen, you know?
I think I was 17 years old is when I finally left. For good. I just had to get out. So overjoyed to be in that place tonight. You don't even understand how many times I have been back and forth to the bush. And I wanted to like take a camera inside so I could share that experience with people. So I was happy about that. I was happy about the girls. They did a real good job.
But tomorrow, I have a surprise for them.
Good evening. Welcome to the Ushu Research Institute. Today we're going to take time out to clarify much of the misconceptions and misunderstanding about healing and nutrition.
This man has shared a lot with me. We look at him as if he was a gift, you know, to come here to this place and to have someone like him around who could help us find us. And he has a very simple philosophy. Guess what? You're not just a physical being, okay? You are an entity with an energy source, you know, that is responsible for, you know, your physical well-being. I mean, I don't care what anybody says about him. You know, he really opened my eyes.
He's an immigrant from Honduras who never went to school, college, or medical school. But the man known as Dr. Sabi claims to have found the cure for several life-threatening diseases, including AIDS. Dr. Sabi believes what ails you can be cured with natural alkaline herbs and a vegetarian diet solely made up of what he calls electric foods, mushrooms, greens, and rye bread without starch.
I don't care what the media puts out and what people read. I believe in him.
We have plums, apples, kiwi, grapes, watermelon, nectarine.
The most important thing in life is to have a very good diet. Get rid of the meat, get rid of the sugar, and please get rid of the sodas.
I've been cleansing on and off for 3 years now.
Sitting on the floor?
Mm-hmm.
Now, these are herbs, everybody. So, I can't wait till we start cleansing. We're gonna start cleansing tomorrow.
Y'all ready to take your herbs?
You know, this is mental.
But it makes you mentally stronger. You know what I mean?
It's like total water.
You can do it. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. It's all in your head.
You just have to
Forget about it. Act like you're not drinking it. You gotta like psych yourself out. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. It's all in your head.
You do it, Jasmine.
It's all in your head. It's all in your head. It's all in your head. Swallow it, swallow it, swallow it.
Swallow it, swallow it.
You got this.
Effort.
Now the people who don't curse.
Effort.
Effort.
Effort. Effort. This is better.
Lisa's about to show y'all how it's supposed to be done.
Lisa is a rider.
I can't deny it. Woo! Refreshing.
We're going hiking, y'all.
I like to be adventurous and learn new things and read, and I like to dabble in books and, you know, different cultures, animals, space.
Astrology is based on planets and stars. Numerology is a system based on numbers
that have a very deep meaning buried within them.
Change. According to astrology and numerology, I'm all about change. In numerology, every number is broken down to a single digit number. When you get to 10, you start adding the numbers together. So 1 plus 0 equals 1. 11 equals 2. I was born on the 27th, that equals 9. 9 is the highest level of change. Like the highest number next to God, according to that system.
So, let me give you something to think about. Inundate your mind with intentions to turn you out.
I'm very, very active when it comes to the writing.
Satisfy my appetite with something spectacular. Check your vernacular, and then I get back to ya.
I find Asian culture interesting. I love the arts, music, dancing. There's so many things.
No, I don't want no scrub. The scrub doesn't gotta can't get no love from me. Hanging on the passenger side of his best friend's ride. Trying to holler at him.
I'm the T.
Tickety, tickety, tickety.
T-Bar.
I'm the Liggy, Liggy. Left eye.
I'm the C.
And a bit of cheers.
And that is L on the TLC tip.
Timing is everything. Time, space, and energy. When I first got in TLC, I was somewhere at the right time with the right people.
Atlanta, Georgia is fast becoming the creative center for urban music. Everything from hip-hop to R&B is being produced here. The days of stars having to move to L.A. or New York are gone. Atlanta is where it's happening now.
Didn't know anybody in Atlanta. Was lucky to have about $750 to my name because I just shot a video. So I thought I was rich. $750 was going to last me. Don't worry about it. I got some money. I'm going to Atlanta. I was looking forward to this new adventure.
I'm T-Buzz. I'm the one that talks like really high and sing low. Yo.
When I met Dion, you know, she had the big earrings that were in style. She had the latest hairdo. She had the fly clothes. And she was beautiful. And she was real cool. She was down to earth.
After we met Pebbles, the third member didn't work out. And that's when we met Chili. She was a dancer for Damian Dame at the time.
Hello?
Yeah.
Chili. She's a character.
Oh,
is so lovable.
T-Boz, Left Eye, and Chili in the house.
Pebbles took us to dinner one night, and she said, I am going to sign you guys. That's when we felt like, oh, man, we made it. When we left out of that restaurant, I mean, we were screaming so loud, I'm surprised that the windows in the car didn't shatter. From that point on, things moved very quickly.
When we first got to the video set, we had a filming mic. You always look at videos and say, dang, I want to be in that video. And you never think you're going to be the person in the front. You know, so when we got there, yeah. It was like, this is our video!
Contributed a lot to the music. Tion's voice is so unique. We didn't sound like anybody, and it was because of Tion. Chili was the person who did a lot of the dancing and the choreography. I think my biggest contribution to the first album was the baggy clothes with the colors and the condoms and the band-aids and little neat stuff I used to do with my glasses and my hat. You know, I contributed a lot to the image.
Left Eye and Chili.
So that's how we put this thing together. There's a certain chemistry that we had. It made magic happen.
We have three different individual styles, but we gel together as a group.
TLC knows how to breathe life into songs, whereas another group could record the same song and it just does not have the same kind of effect.
Hey, if y'all ain't too proud to black, make some noise! All right, check this out.
Yeah, we're funny in the morning or the middle of the night.
I ain't too proud to black!
If the love is strong, then we got it going on.
I ain't too proud!
When people look at TLC, they see something that's authentic. Back in the day, we're like a bunch of kids at the playground. There was so much practical joking. We were having a lot of fun. But at the same time, we wanted it. We were hungry.
My next guests are chart. Topping, hip-hopping, safe sex talking, feminist rapping, singing, fine, condom wearing, fashion styling group of the 90s, performing their latest single, Hat to the Back, from their CD. Ooh, on a TLC tip, please give it up for TLC. Get up!
Very independent, strong young women. Ladies, if you ever feeling down in the dumps, go buy the first album and listen to it. I hope what a lot of females got out of it was that independent feeling. TLC is definitely one of those groups that speaks from the heart, stands. The group, TLC, we had a lot of fun in the beginning. But man, we didn't really realize what we were getting ourselves into.
this morning, rap star Lisa Lopes arrived in
Lisa
court.
Lisa Lopes is involved in another situation.
A troubling and embarrassing episode in her celebrity life.
We have no comment.
Lopes pleaded no contest to obstructing an officer during that arrest.
Me and alcohol. When we get together, it's a different story. There was this girl. They used to call her Nikki. Every time I got drunk, this girl named Nikki would show up. When I got drunk, I was just a different person. I was just somebody that people was just like, man, that ain't Lisa, that's Nikki. And all of a sudden, whenever there was something that happened that Lisa didn't want to take the blame for, she blamed it on Nikki. And this is a totally different person than Lisa. And then, when these two started to battle it out, I had to create a third person to come in and you know, straighten the two of them out. Oh, Nina. Whew. Oh, y'all don't know Nina? My evil twin who came from within, whom I blame all my sins on. I say the problems that I did have stemmed from what I was doing. I was creating all these different personalities.
This is the world's smallest company. Check this.
It's nothing to be embarrassed about.
It just
it out.
So if you have to wear one of those,
don't be embarrassed.
Don't be embarrassed.
Because they do come
in your sound.
What do you think is good sex?
Good sex is safe sex. Never forget that. That's my answer.
Okay.
Good answer. Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Good answer.
Refresh your head about pulling down curtains and breaking the wall back. Yeah, I like it when you both set the lips on the TLC time.
Let me see. I want to say something without saying too much. Dallas did.
Yeah.
Dallas, now I'm just gonna be honest with everybody, okay? Dallas recorded some songs for TLC that we hadn't yet gone in to record, but Dallas tried to charge us about $4.2 million, so he might not be on the project.
She kept it real.
So, you know, we've been fighting with Dallas for about 10 months. We have not yet gone in the studio with Dallas yet, and hey, don't get mad at me, but I had to tell it like it is, so. I was totally 100% against Creep when it was supposed to come out.
Single most important thing in a man is loyalty.
Break it down! Come out! That's what we be talking about!
I almost wore black tape over my mouth in the video, and everybody was like, oh my God, she's being a rebel.
I wasn't down with the cheating on your man. You know, for me, it's be faithful. You know, I was like, if a girl is gonna catch her man cheating, this was my thing. Instead of telling her to cheat back, why don't we tell her to just leave?
Trust me, you can sell 10 million albums and be broke if you have greedy people behind you.
All right, this is how a group can sell. Seems like a lot of money. Well, it's not a lot of money when the record company has spent $3 million to record your album. And in the record business, we pay all costs back to the record company. We pay recording costs, video costs. So now we have $2.6 million left. Then you split the rest three ways. You got about $300,000 apiece, if that much. Okay? $300,000. I can buy a nice house with that. And what am I going to pay my bills with?
It's like some of the things that we go through, it's like, dang, why we always got to be the ones? Why everything has to happen to us?
But at the same time, if we didn't go through the bad times and the struggles and the hard work, we wouldn't be as close as we are. We wouldn't be as strong as we are. We wouldn't be as wise as we are.
What'd you think?
Oh, yeah.
What'd you think?
There are a lot of things that we are misled about. I would like to be one of the people that kind of like removes the smoke and the curtains.
Someone who
says it's the real deal. Now make a business decision based off of the real deal. True in this business that only the strong will survive, because it's much more than just getting up on the stage and fulfilling your dreams. You know, it's a business. The one thing that I've learned the most from being in this business is how to love myself. That's the one thing that I've learned. Yes. It's a dog-eat-dog world out there. So if I don't love me, I won't survive. I've had to learn through all of it that the most important thing in all of it is me. It all starts here. It all starts with you.
Always end up with the person that you never expect to be with. And Andre, I didn't expect to be with him.
I hold my stuff real good. I don't care how stressed I get. It must be some little compartment that holds it all inside of me, but it'll come out one day.
I can't really blame anybody for anything. The only person I can ever blame for anything is myself. Probably the most anybody ever heard me say anything. I never really like just digging deep and, you know, trying to put my emotions out on the table. When I do that, when I do dig into myself, real strange things start.
The Andre situation and how I met him is kind of funny.
I was out at a club, and Andre followed me around that club to the point where I was so annoyed. And it wasn't until maybe 3 or 4 times that I had run into him that we just clicked. And that was the day that I decided to go to his house. I went over to the house, and when I pulled up, he was hanging out of the window waiting for me. Walked in the house, he grabbed my hand, he kissed me on the hand. He was very polite and gentle. He had this big, beautiful house, and it was empty. And I was like, why don't you have any furniture? Because I'm waiting for you to furnish it. I was just like, really now? I mean, that day I went there, I never left. Andre used to tell me, I love you so much.
that I never had a chance to say at first. My line was, I love you too. I love you too. He was very romantic and he was my best friend.
But there were some parts about it that weren't that good.
Andre is a pretty giving person. He gives out his money, his cars, his clothes, you know. But one thing that he is very protective. He's very protective of his girl. You know, you can use anything, but don't even think about looking at my girl.
It was very jealous and very possessive.
I didn't have any freedom. That's a big problem. Freedom. Anything. Ask first. I needed permission to do things.
When we got together, he really didn't like for me to go out too much. So I just didn't go out. And he cheated on me. He's the first guy I ever stayed with who did. I'll never forget. One time when I got home, I went upstairs and the bed is all made and his car is in the driveway. I'm like, what's going on? Where is he at? I went upstairs and he was in the room, in the guest room, but naked. And I just searched the room. I opened the closet door. There's a girl standing in a pink jacket with stockings on. And I was in total shock. I just couldn't believe it. Man, there were so many problems in our relationship.
Andre Rison had just left this night spot with his girlfriend, rap singer Lisa Lopes, and allegedly started beating her.
My mother and my father fought a lot, and, you know, I just react quickly to those kind of situations. So when Andre's grabbing on me and stuff, they turn into fights.
Across the street,
your
neighbor across the street has been house on fire.
How did I burn it down?
If it flames on
one
of the sides of the house.
Let me tell y'all something. He had been staying out late. I decided, all right, I'm gonna flip the script. I'm coming home late with some girls, with a dress on. Like, I just had the time of my life. It's the sun, me and the sun racing home right now. I got home, it was 5 o'clock in the morning. Andre's car still not in the driveway. So, my plan definitely didn't work. He drove up 5 minutes after we drove up. 5 minutes, and Andre's headlights were shining on me. And I was looking back at him like, yeah, motherfucker. And he was looking at me like, what the fuck? Do you have a... He gets out the car, and as soon as he walked up to me, I don't know what he said, but he got slapped for it. He went in the house. I went in the house behind him. So it was just all building up, building up, building up. So now it's all coming out. It's all coming out. Everything that I just kept inside, all my frustrations, I was just enraged. I was about to snap. I was hurt. Next thing you know, he pulled me in the bedroom, and we were fighting. The whole time, I'm screaming, and he grabbed me, throwing me back on the bed, pinning me down, and how could you, and ripping my clothes, and he's just going crazy. And then when I would get up on my feet, and then I would start just beating on him and stuff, you know, he would ball up, and he would just let me take my frustrations out. And I was blasted, I was wasted. I was blacking in and out the whole time. And I woke up, and that's when I walked in the bathroom and looked in the damn mirror. And when I seen my face, I was like, I'm about to kill him. I had a big bruise right here that went from the outside of my lip, flipped the lip under, to the inside. I didn't even recognize myself. I was like, no. No.
And then you wake up to fight.
No, this is not happening. I'm gonna kill him. I was still enraged. I was still hurt. And that's when I went in the closet and I seen all of these new tennis shoes just stacked up. Just stacked up. I was like, wait a minute. All right. One of these better be for me. I didn't see no damn size 4, so them sneakers went right in the bathtub.
So he's staying out late. He's fucking other bitches. He ain't coming home. He ain't buying me no tennis shoes. He ain't even thinking about me. He's totally disrespecting me. He bruised my face. I was just like a mad woman, like just throwing him in there, just like, you're gonna burn. Went under the cabinet, grabbed my lighter fluid that I used to barbecue it, and barbecued me some tennis shoes.
Officials say it started near the back of the home and spread unbelievably fast.
Now I'm hypnotized by the flames. I'm in a trance. Flames are growing. The fire, the intense, everything is just getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. My sister ran in the bathroom. And she pulled me out of the house. At that point, I was just gazing. And when I got outside, I looked at that house, and this feeling came over me like, wow, the house of evil is burnt to the ground. Burning. We left and we went to the hospital, and all of a sudden it was on the news already, 6 o'clock in the morning.
So many stories came out. I never opened my mouth about what happened, but yet people were printing stories like it was the gospel truth.
Lopes sat next to her mother in the back seat of this Mercedes as friends drove her to the police precinct where she surrendered. Police say most of the questioning centered on the circumstances that led this pop singer to allegedly commit arson.
And I was like, don't believe anything you hear and only believe half of what you see. I didn't realize what I was doing. I didn't mean for the house to burn down. I just meant for it to stay in the tub. You know, I didn't realize any of that. So for me, even though I was getting handcuffed, I always had a positive outlook, like everything's going to be okay. I don't see myself going down for 20 years because of an accident, because that's what it was. It was an accident.
According to a police report, when Rizin and a group of friends returned from a nightclub, Lisa Lopes ran from the house out into the driveway and began to slap and curse the victim.
I was like, I am a victim, okay? You got him, like, pegged out to be the victim. You got me looking like an alcoholic.
Lisa has an alcohol problem and has actually had an alcohol problem for some time.
Like, I was just crazy, drunk out my mind, didn't know what I was doing, and just for no reason, just decided to burn down the house when I was abused, like, physically, mentally.
Lopes is a singer with the hip-hop group TLC. What she's accused of doing yesterday is far from tender, loving care.
I was like, I have fans. This is not the picture that I'm trying to create. I'm not trying to be no crazy nutcake. Everybody is like, you know you can go to jail. Do you realize what you did? You burned the house down. And my lawyer is like, your thinking got you into this mess. Let somebody else's thinking get you out.
People could have died. Other houses could have burned. And there's just no way to get around that. And you need to own it and accept it. And there's just no way to get around that. And you need to own it and accept it.
Next thing you know it, I'm almost sitting up in some old detox room, like, what am I doing here?
I sat in like, oh, that's me.
What the hell? This is crazy. A lot of this stuff I write down, I'm disappointed as I write it. And then I'll go back and read it. That was pretty cool. Anyway, this morning started the drama and this evening encompassed it and split. But sunshine filled in the spaces and all's well in the spring. And that, my friends, is my journal.
when it comes to really expressing your feelings on that piece of paper. It's a very fine line between just a poem or a rap. They're really the same thing. And like his promise is true, won't leave my bacon undone. The many chances I blink with and bring my life to an end. Clear blue and unconditional. Skies have dried the tears from my eyes. No one lonely cries. Yeah, the rap in Waterfalls, it's based on a true story. I was in the diversion center at the time, serving out my sentence. I got out on a 2-hour break to go in the studio and listen to the song that TLC was working on, which called Waterfalls. On the way, I was admiring the streets, the buildings, the trees, the sky, and I looked up, it was this rainbow. And I was like, wow, this place we live in never meant so much to me until now. Dreams are hopeless aspirations and hopes are coming true. Believe in yourself, the rest is up to me, yeah. If you read the lyrics, it pretty much describes what was going on around me, where I was at that time in my life. Charter Peachford.
Charter
Peachford.
Why don't you bring out that weed, man?
Drug Rehabilitation Center.
If you know your kid has been smoking pot, find a way to take action.
Charter Peachford. You know them commercials be coming on all the night. Tell me, if you can't get help somewhere, get help at Charter.
More than 4 million young Americans have a drinking problem. Do you?
You always wonder what is going through the mind of a dope fiend. What would make him steal from his own family? Well, I got to spend 30 days with one. People who died and overdosed and was pronounced dead and came back to life. Peddlers peddling this day and there. Then you got rich people. Mm-hmm. People who come in there just because the insurance is going to pay for it. They want a vacation. People who come in there because they can't handle the fact that their dog passed away. You know what I mean? It's just from one extreme all the way to the next. And then you got me, you know, some old hip-hop superstar who burned her boyfriend's house down.
You up in there right with him?
I'm right up in there with him, and we all, every day, we get together and we talk. First thing they tell you to say is, my name is whatever it is, and I'm an alcoholic. That's what they make you say. Well, they ain't, I never said it.
Yeah.
I'm a Gemini. I'm a recording artist.
yeah, I feel you.
I never, and they be looking at me like she's never gonna get it together.
Experienced drill instructors know full well the value of soldierly conduct, order, obedience, and hard work.
You might still have my picture hanging up in there.
Oh, really?
Cause I made the best bed. I have my closet, my locker was the cleanest. They used to come in my room and be putting stuff up in the hallway. This is what your bed should look like.
Beds are made. Beds that will be welcome after days of exacting drill.
They sitting up there showing me how to make a bed. And I'm like, I've been making my bed like this since I was a baby. Military style, I had no idea that what my father was teaching us was military stuff. When I was in the rehabilitation program, my father was on my mind heavy.
My father died
4 years earlier. Him and a distant cousin used to go at it all the time. And one night they just got into this really, really, really bad dispute. My father, he, you know, drinks, he gets a little bit crazy. But the other guy shot him. You know, they're having an argument.
I felt great loss, you know, when he passed. I think that the rehabilitation program helped me in a lot of different areas because I spent a lot of time sitting around thinking.
And I realized that everybody has problems. Okay? Everybody has problems. And you can't always blame that person for their problems because everybody is a result of their environment. So before I get mad at my daddy because he was crazy, I'd be just trying to think, what the hell did his mama do to him? And what the hell did her mama do to her? And so on and so forth. Where you at? You know, somebody gotta be smart enough to break the cycle so my kids ain't gotta be talking about me like that.
I'm sorry.
adopted a little girl, and her name is Snow.
Snow, you know how to play piano? We're gonna teach you, okay?
She's just a little busybody. She's so advanced that she doesn't know what to do with herself. So we're gonna take Snow and give her the proper love and attention that she needs.
You know, children have such a great energy about themselves that it just spreads. You can't help but to feel it. It's contagious.
Give it all up, TLC!
When Crazy Sexy Girl came out, it blew up. And I know it had much more to do with just the music. I know for a fact that the fire helped.
While promoting Crazy Sexy Cool as an apparent Joker publicity stunt, Left Eye and Company appeared in firefighters gear on the cover of Vibe magazine.
You can be the hottest group in the world, but if nobody knows who you are, you're not gonna sell any records. TLC, Left Eye, Lisa Lopes was heavily publicized because of that incident, because of the fire. And I didn't have a problem with it, because personal things that we go through goes with the music.
People aren't only interested in the music, but they're interested in us.
They're all so strong, yeah. All what they've gone through.
I love those girls. They're my babies.
Yo, Left Eye! Hit that one time!
With this album, we felt pretty confident that we had something major on our hands.
The winner is TLC.
We are the biggest selling female group ever.
And the winner is
TLC, y'all.
10 million albums worldwide.
Shout out to Army, Charter Pittsburgh, the Atlanta Police Department.
We were still having a lot of fun. But on the inside, I was thinking, is there anything else to this than making videos and winning awards? Am I going to be able to pursue other dreams that I have because of this? What I like best about my job is I'm basically my own boss.
All right, here's my picture, everybody.
Wow.
All right, now as everybody can see, I'm sitting on top of the world. This is my goals. That represents a solid team. For my business. That embryo represents a child. Over here, you see like this real strong muscular arm with my heart in his hand. That represents my man. Hopefully it'll be my husband. This right here represents money. Money, money, money.
Good morning, everybody.
All right, we need you to bring your arms up. 5, 4, 3. Inhale. Exhale.
This is good. We're in the bush. We just got finished making breakfast. And I finally got a chance to eat my grits and avocados, and it is.
I haven't had energy like this since almost last year.
Can you say that for the camera?
Oh, yes, the herbs, y'all. Seriously. This is honest to God's truth. It gives me so much energy, for real. Like these last 2 days.
I don't know about her, but it gives me gas.
Shut up.
Wasn't trying to kill myself. I wasn't gonna die. Wasn't afraid. I knew I was gonna cut myself and there was gonna be some blood.
I did this around 7 years ago. It said love first, and then I wrote hate on it. And as you can see, I can't even see love anymore.
I carved love in my arm with a Lady Bic razor, one of those pink Bics. I carved, I love Dre. Can you see it? I was in need of some attention. I was a little hurt, a little angry. I was serving time in the diversion center. And I don't know, he really wasn't really coming to visit like I would have wanted him to. And I was frustrated. There's no telling where he was, you know, where he had been and who he was dealing with while I was serving time. Love turned into hate because we had a barbecue and he accused me and his friend of flirting and saying really mean things. So I was so frustrated and I went and grabbed the razor and over top of the word love, I started writing the word hate, H-A-T-E. And look how nice it came out.
I have premonitions.
Dreams. I think it's the energy in the air.
There were times I just thought I was gonna die. All right, can y'all see me? All right. I just gotta tell y'all that I had a real frightening dream last night. I dreamed that I woke up and I looked at the sun and it was like a fourth of the size of the earth. That's how big it was. And you know what? I asked you. Mm-hmm. I said, Kurt, is that the sun? Because it almost looked like the moon, but it was just, it was bigger than you've ever seen the moon or the sun or anything before. And he said, yeah, that's the sun. We're in trouble. Oh, man. I'm trying to figure out what the rest of the dream was. Anyway, it was basically the end. Today is the 22nd day here in the bush. Okay, and we have 8 more days to go. This is our last week here. We have much more to do, but this is what happens. And I always just, man, I always do this. I can never even complete a project for coming up with a new great idea and jumping on to the next one. At the same time, that has a lot to do with the reason why I've had success. Am I surprised that I'm a superstar? Oh, let me see. That's a tricky question. I'm not surprised that I am a superstar because I have very high
expectations of myself, and I set my goals very high.
And the winner is TLC. This is totally unexpected.
TLC has achieved a lot, but there's so many more things that I would love to do in the future.
I bought the property next door, about 50 acres, for Camp Yak. It stands for Youth Activity Center, Youth Adventure Center, Youth Athletic Center, Youth Academic Center.
¿Cuántos años?
Nueve.
¿Y tú?
Doce.
I'm on a 40-day fast. It pretty much cleanses your mind. It definitely cleanses your body on just a physical level, and your body, your physical body pretty much governs your energetic body.
Here they are, TLC. Obviously, we are one short. We're missing the L in TLC, left eye. She okay? Yeah.
She's not. Well, don't get mad, but...
What's wrong?
She don't feel good.
She doesn't feel
she
good.
Feel okay.
All I have to say is, Imodium AD, put it together.
Okay. I can't believe you just said that. Left Eye is throwing stuff at the TV right now if she's watching.
I can't believe she said that.
I can't stand 100% behind the TLC project and the music that's supposed to represent me.
Okay.
And the group. I would like to present the first challenge in the history of music. I challenge TLC to a 3-CD set. I challenge LaFace Records to put $1 million prize on the winner to release 3 singles at once.
On the winner, though, between the three of you?
Between the three of us.
Well, let's see. When that happened, it's because
I was thinking, well, what's better than showing up and being the star? Not showing up. So I didn't show up, and I was the star. So instead of flying to California and doing the press conference, I got in my car and was like, I'm driving to the bush. Cross country, like a cross country road trip.
Right.
From Atlanta through Mexico down all the way to Central America. Always wanted to drive. So it was my opportunity. But I just told my whole staff, look, I'm out.
It's the question everyone is asking. Where in the world is Lisa Left Eye Lopez?
No one seems to know what happened. That's why everyone's so worried.
We're in the front. What page?
Left Eye at the top of the pickle. Although she's been sighted in New Orleans, Los Angeles, New York, and Honduras, Lisa Left Eye Lopez is still among the missing.
Man, you took that kind of hard. I didn't know they were going to take it that hard.
sometimes when you're in a group, limitations are set because you like to respect everyone's, you know, creative differences. Being a solo artist, I pretty much get to say whatever I want to say, however I want to say it. I did all the artwork and design for the album. A supernova is a rare star that increases up to a billion times its normal shine. I've been going back and forth with the record company, but the official release date is August 16th, 2001. There are magic in those numbers to me, 162001, that equals 10. And according to numerology, 10 is symbolic of a star. It's gonna explode like a bomb. I just want to leave and get lost.
Guess the best thing to do is just play on and just
spend a little bit of time with myself. That's something I haven't done in a long time.
This is my room, everyone. My beautiful room, I miss it. My chair that I painted. My map. And me, if you can see me.
Even though we're documenting this, it's some things you still cannot, or we haven't been able to document. Even though we're taping as much as we're taping, there's still, people will still never feel the true essence of
She chose for me to wake y'all up so you could be there at the beginning of the workout.
And we were.
No, you weren't there at the beginning of the workout.
Not at the beginning, but we'll be there.
You know, we had some issues.
Honestly, Stephanie.
Don't put me on. I think y'all need to be tighter. It's the last week and y'all need to come tighter.
Get off my back, okay? Just get off my back. You don't put your bull fuse in me, okay? Just
right.
Chill with that, okay?
All right.
Chill with the, you don't get on me about nothing.
That tone is set.
You understand? Don't get on me about nothing. Thank you.
Boy, I never realized how hungry I was till I got in here.
Joy, put it back now. Record on camera.
I'm about to shut this camera off because ain't nobody going to see what kind of fattening foods I'm about to buy.
This documentary was so that people can get to know me up close and personal.
But now I'm trying to figure out
why I'm doing this. It just seems like certain situations and events have gravitated towards
this project.
Things that I could not see, I asked to see. Things that I could not hear, I asked to hear. I'm still trying to figure it out.
We're on the 25th day, and we have 5 days left. I can't wait to get back in the studio and really work.
There's so many things to do, but my mind is everywhere.
Down a hill in a car, knowing you're going to hit something at the bottom, never stepping on the brakes.
These are? These are the shoes that belong to the little boy. And his last name was Lopes. Ain't that something? I don't think I will ever get over it.
I personally do not believe in death. I believe in transformation.
We're almost there.
I do believe that there is an afterlife.
We all share the same space. So no matter what form you may be in, here or not here, you may be dust, we still share the same space. There we go. We're all around. When someone passes away, look up, a new star is born.
We can get some shots.
Just get footage of the whole, the vibe. You know what I mean?
Thank you.
I believe that your life is defined by what you believe in. And I believe that
every time that there is a struggle, it is nothing but a preparation for what's yet to come.
I think my life represents change. I love change. Try to change for the better. I'm changing right now.
My dream is keep going forward and never go backwards.
There's so many things to explore. It never ends.